In today's video, we're making Christmas ornaments from dinner plates. It's called Peak Ossiette Mosaic, and I'll show you how to use it to create a cohesive collection, even if the ornaments have different shapes and colors. Let's get to it. Welcome back, and if you're new here, my name is Julie. And on this channel, we talk about tips, tricks, tools, adhesives, materials, and specific mosaic projects, all to shorten your learning curve when it comes to creating mosaic art. So if that sounds like something you'd be interested in, please consider subscribing. Peak Ossiette is a popular style of mosaic, and it has a unique way of telling a story. Peak Ossiette means thief of plates in French, and you may know it as memory ware, shard ware, or bits and pieces. It's a collage of plates, bowls, mugs, crockery, figurines, and maybe even some found objects. I've done a few videos here on the channel about Peak Ossiette mosaic and projects that involve Peak Ossiette mosaic, and I'll link them down below in the description so you can check them out. My client requested 8 mosaic ornaments, 5 from her dinner plates and 3 from a lamp that belonged to her grandparents. In today's video, I will focus on the 5 dinner plates, and if you'd like to see the 3 from the table lamp, I'll link that down below in the description as well. To give you a little background, my client and her husband are celebrating their 25th wedding anniversary, and they wanted some sentimental keepsakes created to remember the occasion. So she sent me some of her wedding plates. Now keep in mind, this is her wedding china. She didn't really use it very often, if at all. It's more sentimental. They were wedding gifts, and she just liked to remember that special day. And now I get to break them and have some mosaic fun. We've got a lot to cover, so let's get started. So my client had very little requests or restrictions. Basically, she needed 5 ornaments and I needed to involve her wedding plates somehow. I could choose any shape I wanted. I could incorporate any materials that I wanted. Talk about a dream client. I love that. She also did not want to have any progress pics sent to her. She didn't want to know what was going on with them. She wanted to be completely surprised. So I got started with picking out some of the wood shapes. I knew I wanted 5 different shapes, but was open to traditional Christmas motifs and non-traditional. Once I picked out the 5, I got started with sealing the fronts and backs. I've done a video here on the channel about how to seal wood for mosaic, and I'll link that down below in the description. When sealing pieces, I like to work on wax paper. Once the pieces are dry, they peel right off the paper. It's really handy. Next, I got started tiling, and I will go over each ornament so that you can have a closer look. And then I will finish off with a step-by-step of how I created the last ornament. That one is a bit more involved. First up is the heart ornament. For this one, I knew I wanted to use the outside border from my client's plates as the border of the heart, and I wanted to use metallic gold in the center. I went back and forth in my mind about what material to use in the background. Ultimately, I decided to go with the teal color from the rim of my client's plates. I'm happy with the simplicity of this ornament, and it's got just a little contrast with the metallic gold center. Next up was the package or gift ornament. Tiling the bow had me very excited, I have to admit. I knew it was going to be a good challenge, if you know what I mean. Those curves were so much fun. I used red vitreous tile for the bow and ribbon, and then filled in the package with teal from my client's plates. This next ornament was a throwback shape to something our grandparents would have had on their tree, or at least it reminded me of that. So I wanted it to be a little more ornate, so to speak, than the previous 2 I had tiled. I wanted to create some sort of design in the center. I just wasn't quite sure what that would look like. So I laid out the plate pieces where I knew I wanted them to go, and then got started with laying out vitreous tile pieces. I decided on a design and cut the three colors of vitreous, then got to tiling. Keystoning the tile in the center made all the difference in keeping this design tight so that it could remain small but make a really big impact in the center of this ornament. Then I filled in all the background with the teal from my client's plates. I added metallic gold at the top to add a little bit of holiday shimmer. Next up is this round ornament, and this one is my favorite. I have to admit, I love it. I knew I wanted to create a more contemporary, sleek, clean, like a less is more feel to this ornament, and I wanted to include a back stamp from the client's plates. So I cut out a couple to play with. Because I didn't know if I wanted to include both, keeping one fully intact and the other cut down a bit, or use just one. Ultimately, I decided on using just one. So next I cut some of the white portion of my client's plates and got to tiling. I wanted these pieces, along with the back stamp, to be more prominent on the ornament. Then I cut smaller pieces of the teal portion of my client's plates and even smaller pieces of red vitreous and metallic gold ceramic. And I used more metallic gold ceramic to finish off the top of the ornament. I love it. Now, the fifth and final ornament is this Christmas tree. Gotta have a Christmas tree hanging from the Christmas tree, right? So I'll take you through the steps on how I created this mosaic. It's definitely the most involved of the group. So to start, I knew exactly what I wanted to do design-wise with this ornament. I wanted circles cut from the rim of my client's plates and then include the teal portion of the plates for the tree branches. Before I got started with cutting, I drew the tree branches on the substrate just to give me an idea of what size pieces I should cut for the branches, but also how were things going to flow. Next, I placed yellow vitreous for the star up top and the brown vitreous at the bottom for the tree trunk, just to make sure the shades would work well together. And they did. Then I cut small triangles for the star and glued them down, and then did the same for the trunk pieces at the bottom. Next up was cutting the circles out of the plate rims. I used a common household drill and special drill bits to do this. You can watch that video here on the channel, and I'll include a link down below in the description so you can check it out. And I will say, it is a fascinating process and one that was pretty addicting for me. Once I drilled the circles, and I drilled way more than I needed, but was having so much fun that I didn't want to stop, I then started placing the circles randomly on the ornament. And once I was happy with how it looked, I glued all of them down. So next are the tree branches, and I decided to mix in a few other greens along with the teal from my client's plates. I didn't want a teal tree, but rather a more green tree. So I incorporated a couple olive greens and a darker green along with the teal. It'll give the tree branches more interest and a little depth. I cut the pieces in slivers that look a lot like elongated triangles. And I started placing them in a somewhat random pattern like what you would find in nature. And once I was done tiling, I let it sit and dry just like the other four ornaments. I then moved on to tile ornaments using my client's lamp from her grandparents. And I'll link that video down below in the description. The ornaments have been sitting here drying, and now they're ready to be grouted. I'm using the same color grout for all of the ornaments, which is dark gray. I've mixed up my grout and I'm ready to get started. Once the ornaments have been cleaned off and the grout has cured, I like to finish off the back by painting the pieces and signing them. You always want to sign your artwork. Then I topped off all of those layers with a good quality sealant. After all of those layers are dry, the ornaments are ready for hangers. Each ornament is hung by a black velvet ribbon. Lately, I've really been into using velvet ribbon with the mosaic ornaments. I think it adds a lot of contrast. Velvet is, it's tough, it's durable, it's soft, it's luxe, and it holds up really well to the harsh and hard surfaces of mosaic. Taking into account what I accomplished today, let's talk about how you can create a cohesive collection of ornaments, even if you're not using the same colors from ornament to ornament, or they aren't the same shapes. The first way I was able to do this was, of course, I started with the client's plates, incorporating small pieces of the same exact material can help the continuity of one ornament to the next. Even if the shapes of the ornaments are sort of a mixed bag of traditional holiday themes and non-traditional themes. Another way is to use the same grout color for all of the pieces. This can show that these ornaments are together. A third way is to hang all of the ornaments from the same exact material. Same fabric, same color, same thickness. And in this case, all of these ornaments hung from black velvet ribbon. And a final, very subtle way, I try to make this group feel like a cohesive collection was to paint the backs and sides of all five of them the same color. Now, of course, you're not going to see the sides and the back very often, but sometimes ornaments can get turned around while on the branches. Some other ways that you can make a collection seem cohesive, you could use the same design from one ornament to the next. You can use different colors, but it's the same design. Another way would be to make all of the ornaments the same shape, but just use different colors, use different designs. But keeping that shape the same will look cohesive. Question of the day, let me know down in the comments if you've ever created a series or collection of Christmas ornaments. How many did you make? What shape were they? What materials did you use? I'd love to hear all of the details. Thank you so much for watching. Please give this video a thumbs up as it really does help my channel, and subscribe if you haven't already. Click the bell notification so you never miss a single upload. And let me know in the comments if there's something you'd like me to cover in a future video. I'll see you soon. Bye. Focus. 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 That one was a good one. What do you think, huh? Good stuff? Peak Ossiette. Love it. I think that was good.
Yeah. How are you? I feel blown out. Very bright.
Hold up.
Gosh, I can't believe we're coming up on the holidays. Crazy, crazy, crazy. Time is just flying on by. Oh yeah.
If you're looking for more mosaic inspiration, you could check out one of these two videos. Until then, see ya.